What's a candidate known for climbing onto counters do to kick it up a notch? That's Beto O'Rourke climbing on top of a minivan, his campaigns, to address a crowd that couldn't fit into the coffee shop he was headed for. And after he slid down, he went inside the shop and climbed on that counter. Though even up there, he was sometimes blocked from view.
I promise to personally clean your counter before I leave, okay?
He gave it a quick wipe afterwards, and he always asked permission beforehand.
Johnny, are you okay with me getting up here?
He's done it so often, there's a Twitter account called Beto on Counters that includes him standing on chairs. Even at 6'4", he can get lost in the crowd, hence the counter hopping. Besides,
how's everybody doing?
It could serve as a subtle dig at rivals in their 70s. Can you imagine Trump, Biden, or Bernie doing this? One onlooker tapped Beto's leg to alert him.
Hey,
to get off a glass plate, sometimes he suddenly vanishes.
Thank you for asking the question.
He likes to crouch on the counter as well, which seems to defeat the purpose, except when he wants to answer someone's question eye to eye. Someone tweeted, "Oh God, is he pulling a Tom Cruise again? Remember Leaping Tom on Oprah's couch?"
Have you ever felt this way?
Beto has made the leap to internet meme, photoshopped on a McDonald's counter, on top of a podium while debating President Trump, even portrayed as President O'Rourke addressing the nation from the Oval Office. You'd think counter climbing was an Olympic event, judging by the cheers. For Beto's counterattack, Genimo, CNN.
Thank you for allowing me to stand on your counter.
New York.